Hi, it's Jonas. I'm a first year PhD student at the Aphrius Research Center in Hanover, Germany, and I will summarize our work on interpretable semantic photogeolocation. The main task is basically to estimate the location of a photo without making any assumptions or restrictions. For example, on the image content like indoor images or specific locations like landmarks. As an individual cannot capture all locations on the Earth, and thanks to the success of CNNs, current approaches obtain superhuman performance. But due to the black box property of deep neural networks in general, we cannot interpret their results. In our paper, we contribute two methods to improve the interpretability and explainability for a geolocation model. While the task of geolocation estimation is not restricted to, for instance, landmarks, related work divide the Earth into cells, which is called partitioning. And the basic idea is to train a CNN on some kind of classification. It revealed that the construction of the partitioning is the key for success. The S2 method, as shown in the upper right, divides the Earth into a hierarchy of quadtrees based on a data set distribution, where a cplanet lower right initializes results randomly and performs refinement also based on the dataset distribution. It also turned out that multi-partitioning of the S2 partitioning leads to state-of-the-art results, as the model jointly learns to localize at multiple spatial scales. As the aforementioned partitionings rely on arbitrary or rectangular shaped cells, we propose a semantic partitioning that incorporates data derived from OpenStreetMap. These cover territorial, natural, and as well man-made boundaries, and makes the model's output and learning process more natural or explainable by default. Further, we investigate the post-hoc interpretability of a model by measuring the influence of semantic visual concepts on a prediction, and provide insights which features here concepts contribute to a correct or incorrect prediction. Just a few words about how the semantic partitioning is constructed. Similar to the majority of approaches in the related work, we start with a dataset that contains GPS coordinates and images distributed over the Earth's surface. We apply a method called reverse geocoding to assign each coordinate an address vector and construct a hierarchy as shown on the right side. A subset of the hierarchy forms basically the partitioning. In our case, controlled by one parameter, the minimum number of images required to keep the location. For fair comparison with state-of-the-art, we compare a multi-partitioning S2 model from Müller, Budak et al. By fixing the entire setup. In particular, we use the same data, CNN, backbone, the same training parameters, and comparable number of classes. Experimental evaluation have demonstrated that we achieve similar or better results than other approaches on common benchmark datasets, while at the same time, the output provided to the user feels more comprehensible and better reflects specific locations or areas on the world. Our second contribution is the concept influence that requires a segmentation and explanation map. Given this information, we provide a score that should approximate the attribution of an individual concept with respect to model's prediction. We took a set of images with known ground truth locations and aggregate the concept influence score and group by geolocation error. Experiments have shown, no surprise, that concepts like tower or building support for a more accurate estimation, while window pane, tree, flower can give features to a rough estimate. And lastly, that roads or sidewalks do not provide visual cues for any kind of estimation. Furthermore, we found that the border between specific concepts is of interest for the model, for example, a skyline or mountain range.